What's up, guys? Today's junk. Sometimes when progress doesn't go the way you want, you got to really just chalk it up as a learning lesson instead of getting frustrated. So this weekend is a Memorial Day weekend. It's currently Sunday morning and it's about 6:30 in the morning. And I'm at our upstate New York property that we're trying to develop. And currently we are in the process of building a foundation for this thing. But my inexperience and insecurity of not knowing exactly what to do kind of led me to do some things a little backwards that is costing us time and it's becoming more inefficient of a process. So we have this idea to build a shipping container cabin and we want to do concrete pier foundation. Now, I've never done anything like this. I don't know the first thing about doing anything like this, especially by myself. We are thinking about doing three rows of three piers, so nine total, and it'll be a two shipping containers kind of parallel to each other. Anyway, so my thought was, my previous visit, which was a couple of weeks ago, I rented an excavator, and I dug three trenches that are parallel to each other to give me spots for those piers, and my thinking was I'll figure out where the piers go later. At least now I got the holes dug. Come to find out, that is definitely not the right way to do it. I came up this weekend to lay out the strings and use a plumb bob and figure out exactly where the footings for the piers are going to go, center everything. I got measurements, and I can't lay the strings out with the dirt that I removed from the holes in the trenches in the way. So either I get out the shovel and I spend the weekend shoveling and just don't have anything done, because it'll take a lot more than one guy and a shovel to get that done. Yeah, so I took a step backwards, and almost getting that excavator last time was a waste. But this is a lesson learned. This is something I guess I should have realized, but again, my inexperience and insecurity and not knowing exactly how to do it all kind of led me to this decision. But all is not lost. My plan now is to get an excavator again, fill the holes back in, lay out properly with the help of possibly my father. He volunteered to come up one weekend and help me lay this out, but I really do need somebody else to help me do this, because it's, from what I understand, it's a two-man job to do the stakes and lay out the string and get it all perfectly right. I guess it could be done with one person, but that person better know what they're doing. So if I get a second person up here, ideally this person would have done something like this in their past and have a better idea than me. So again, lesson learned. On top of that, Tina's been at home by herself managing the house, and there's always something going on with her parents and the dogs and the chickens and what have you. So I'm not there to help. And while I was gone, there was a water leak at the house. And thankfully, Tina handled it, but that's going to be my job when I get home, is to address it permanently. Anyway, this has been a drag of a weekend and quite disappointing, but I have to keep looking at it as lesson learned. And in the future, when I go to do something like this later, it might be nice to have this as a practice, so to speak, because I'm going to be building all kinds of stuff here at the homestead. And a lot of those structures are going to need permanent foundations. So I'm going to learn by trial and error and help from people like my father and, you know, YouTube and you guys and what have you. But a couple silver linings this weekend, besides all that nonsense of missing Tina like crazy, she's not able to get up here because of her taking care of her parents and me being the only one who really can come up here and have any hope of getting anything done, except for this weekend. A couple silver linings. Tina packed me world-class dinners. Man, I had steak dinner last night. I grilled on my little portable propane grill. Came out amazing. A little butter, salt, and pepper, corn on the cob, and a baked potato. I was eating like a king. And I do feel guilty because Tina wasn't here. And I was up in New York, kind of like enjoying the quiet. No traffic, no people. I mean, it was great, and I do feel very guilty. But I ate great, and I also picked up a drone. I got the DJI Mini 2, and I'll roll in some footage for this now. And yeah, let's give you a quick tour of the homestead with the drone. So that's that. Lessons learned. You know, you're gonna make mistakes in anything that you do. And myself, I feel very guilty and disappointed, like I said, that Tina wasn't able to come up. She's at home, and I literally got almost nothing done. But we'll she we shall see. We shall see. We will see in the future. Again, I'm going to get another excavator, fill in the holes, and then use it for the rest of that day to continue clearing the land you see behind me. It's just little itty bitty baby progress steps, and you know, we'll be making much more progress soon. After I get the foundation figured out and determined, it is then hire a guy to come in with some concrete. Then it's get the shipping containers dropped off, and then it's hire a crew to get the shipping containers on the foundation using a crane. So those three steps are completely taking me out of the equation. So with that in mind, if I can just get the foundation figured out, it'll all be an expensive downhill battle from there, getting those three things done. Once the shipping container is on its foundation, then it's me building the inside and cutting holes for windows and doors and such. And I have way more confidence doing stuff like that than I do building the foundation, but whatever. That's that. Well, if you guys like this video, please click like, comment below, share the video, and most importantly, subscribe. As always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Getting Junk Done. And I have an edited video, which is what you're watching now, every Thursday about 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I do a live stream with my beautiful wife, most Sunday nights, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks for watching.